I guess you could say thematically, technology plays a big part, sort of like a heightened version of a near future reality. And I guess it kind of explores the way that we interact with what's available to us, how we're advancing, how we're progressing based on how we're advancing, and then really just kind of like how we relate to each other, aside from all the technology stuff, how we relate to each other.
About a world in which not just rides in cars or Airbnb hotels or whatever, but literally everything is rated on a 5-star system. So as you walk down the street and someone says hi to you, you can give that person 5 stars or 3 stars. And you have a personal ranking that's just for your overall being that determines a lot about where you stand in society. And so it's a very oppressive system. It's led to a lot of people kind of burying their anger in exchange for more 5-star votes. And it sort of explores what would happen if someone butted up against someone who was very invested in that system were failed by that system. That's sort of the basic idea.
It always attracts a fantastic cast as well. Can you talk about the wonderful talents that feature in your install?
Yeah, well, Bryce Dallas Howard, Alice Eve. Can you say everybody?
Yeah, Joe Wright directed it.
Joe Wright directed it.
Yeah, it was really, we got one email from Charlie Brooker, who created the show, that was like, hey, good news, Joe Wright's directing it, Alice Eve is in it, Bryce Dallas Howard's in it, and we were like, sounds good. Like, seems like you got things under control, buddy.
Yeah, it's great. I mean, I've worked with Netflix a little bit, and I love the model. They really, really trust the people who create their shows and, you know, and support the talent, which is great.
What I love about Black Mirror is the writing. It was a great, great script and kind of irresistible script, really. Also, it being an anthology series means that one's making a short film. So one has kind of control over it, I guess. The stories are wrapped in this kind of high concept. But really what they're about is human interaction or lack of interaction, how people relate to each other.
Talking about human interaction, the beautiful Bryce is standing next to you now, one of your stars, and of course Alice Eve. What was your experience like working with some of these luminous ladies?
Well, I love Bryce. She's amazing. And we met 10 years ago when I was casting Atonement, and I thought she was fabulous and completely wrong for that film. But I'd always had this idea that one day I'd like to work with her.
And I guess my final question, what are you most hoping that people take away from your particular installment of the show?
Oh, I never know how to answer that question. I have nothing to teach people. I'm not trying to tell people what to do or think. Hopefully they'll just have a good time watching it.
When I was growing up, I would read like a ton of sci-fi. Like that's my mom is a total Trekkie, and I remember being a kid and just like inhaling like Isaac Asimov and then Shirley Jackson and Margaret Atwood and when you break it down, what sci-fi is it's the question of what if, you know, what if happened. And I think that what, you know, with the greatest sci-fi, it's really a cautionary tale, and it, in a way, sort of prepares you for what's ahead. And, you know, the greatest sci-fi writers, they need to be futurists. They need to be able to not only kind of predict what's coming ahead, but they need to be able to contextualize it in a way that we can start to make choices now that can hopefully lead us, you know, toward the light as opposed to toward the dark, hence, you know, Black Mirror. And so I think that it's... I mean, this is an incredible platform right now that we're able to have this show be on Netflix, and that something that normally would be kind of like a niche genre is going to be exposed on October 21st to 190 countries worldwide. And that's cool. For the sci-fi lover in me, that's really awesome.
Talking about the future, can I get your reaction to the news officially that we are getting a Jurassic World trilogy, according to your director?
Wait, when did that come out?
Yesterday.
No way, really? I mean, I've known that, but that's awesome. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. That's cool. That's very...
How do you feel?
Well, I mean, how do you think? Yeah.
Really good.
So when I binge watch series, I get into like, okay, so it happened, say, with The Bachelor. So I got really into The Bachelor. And then it's like you need to find out like who that, what The Bachelor's journey was. So you go to the previous season of The Bachelorette and then you work all your way back and then you start moving forward. And I have a thing with some reality television for sure. But any kind of series, like I remember binge watching 6 Feet Under. I'd never seen 6 Feet Under, and I watched it from start to finish just over the course of a few weeks. And I was crying so much at that last episode. My husband rushed into the room being like, oh my gosh, what's happened to my wife? I think stories can impact you that much more when you watch them with very little gaps in between. What's super secret geeky about me? Like everything. What is it?
Play with dinosaurs.
With dinosaurs.
Cosplay at home.
I can't help but take like 20 books with me wherever I go. But I wouldn't. I don't know. I wear dorky pajamas.
I think the series just invites us to look at the ways that we interact with technology and the sort of tacit agreements that are being made all the time for technology to take over more and more aspects of our lives in ways that make our lives easier, but there's some penalty probably at the end. So the series thematically sort of is cloaked in this dread of the next phase of technology that we're all agreeing to. But our episode, I think, is quite hopeful and optimistic, and it's one of the few sort of emotional refuges of Black Mirror that feel sort of like not everything is bleak.
What can you tell us about your character and about your installment of Black Mirror?
Well, I can tell you that it's a coming-of-age story about two women set in the 80s. The people who work on the show are so brilliant and lovely and very just fun to be around while being real geniuses. So it's the whole thing's just been a dream. And working with Gugu and Owen and Charlie and Annabelle, the whole thing has been such a... it's so cool to work on something that you love so much and also have the people be so normal, fun to be around. Yeah, I guess I think it's quite hard to be so... critical of technology and of the way that we're developing without being sort of cold and cynical about it. I feel like there's still this hardened Black Mirror that makes you want to keep watching, where it's not just constant despair and the drudgery of human existence. There's this idea that not everything is awful, even though we should be critical of this thing that we're agreeing to engage with. And Charlie's so multifaceted, and he doesn't write just a blanket morality statement about our use of technology or our way of exploiting it. I don't know. I think he's really cool.
I agree. Thank you so much. We're going to pass you on. Thank you. You're working, of course, on the Blade Runner sequel as well at the moment. I'm curious, what do you think is the magic of intelligent sci-fi fantasy?
That it's grounded in some sort of emotional reality. So it's not about creating an alternate reality. It's about expanding upon a very real emotional reality that we're already living in. And it's quite easy to make us scared if you keep it close to home. And I feel like that's a Black Mirror, and what Blade Runner does to a large degree is by extending it to its logical degree, but not making it so distant that we can other it.
You always have the luxury of working with some great talent. What's it like, particularly at the moment, I guess, working with a legend like Harrison Ford?
I've never met him, so I have no idea, but I'm excited that he's in the movie.
Of course, after that, you have the Deadpool sequel, which fans already can't get enough of. I guess the obvious question, what does it mean for you to be a part of that world?
I am not in that movie. I'm not sure how that rumor came about, but I'm...
Because seriously, that's officially on IMDb and everything. We need to talk to someone about
it. IMDb is... It's really a weird thing because it's just a publicly... it's like Wikipedia. It's just people put what they think in it. It's not an actual living document.
Wishful thinking.